What is inside the Internet of India? How are Indians using the mobile to find unusual answers to common problems? What impact has the government's flagship Digital India campaign had over the last 2 years? And what are the gaps that Indian startups can fill to make the internet relevant for the new user? We find out on a 3,800-kilometer Digital Desh drive across North India.
The Young Turks 14 Years.
Hello and welcome to this special presentation by CNBC TV 18 in partnership with NowFloats and Google India. I'm Shireen Bhan. With the cost of smartphone handsets coming down drastically, there's been an explosive growth in the number of Indians accessing the internet from their phones. Touted as the world's biggest mobile-first market, India seems to be at an inflection point, and the way new-to-internet users harness the power of the net will determine the fate of some of the world's biggest businesses. It's no surprise then that the CEOs of some of the world's biggest enterprises, from Apple to Microsoft, from Google to Facebook, are making the beeline for India. But while numbers are drawing eyeballs, people actually tell stories. Digital Desh aims to unravel exactly how people in Tier 2, 3 and even 4 cities are using technology in their everyday lives.
On the show, we travel with the Minister of Communication and IT, Ravi Shankar Prasad, to Mathura to understand what the government's flagship Digital India campaign has yielded on ground. We meet an entrepreneurial duo from Jodhpur who are selling everything from pure breed Marwari horses to World War Jeeps online. What can companies ranging from WhatsApp to mobile wallets to e-commerce giants do to service a new-to-internet customer base? And we find out from industry veterans what they would like to see happen next. The first stop on this Deshrakshan road trip, Mathura. Mathura is a typical Tier 3 city with the predictable signs of unplanned urbanization. The mayhem in Mathura over the last fortnight, while alarming, is not altogether unimaginable. But the scene just a few days prior to the violence breaking out was a very different one. On May 30, Minister of State for Communications and IT, Ravi Shankar Prasad, and Member of Parliament from Mathura, Hema Malini, flogged off the Digital India outreach campaign from the heart of the city. In the first phase of this outreach campaign, 16 of these digital vans will cover 34 districts of 9 states. The mission is to educate the public about the real, tangible benefits they can avail by getting online.
आज ये बहाना हमें मिला आपसे बात करने का, आपसे मुलाकात करने का, और ये बहाना दिया हमें हमारी भारत सरकार ने।
अरे जन सेवा केंद्र पर आप पंजीकरण करा सकते हैं अपने पोते का।
हाँ हाँ, जन्म पंजीकरण
और मृत्यु पंजीकरण भी हो जाता है वहाँ।
हो गया,
आधार कार्ड भी अप्लाई कर सकते हैं।
अच्छा,
हाँ मास्टर जी, और तो और वहाँ राशन कार्ड बन जाता है।
ओहो,
अरे दूसरी बात, अच्छी बात ये है कि अपना बिजली का बिल, पानी का बिल, मनरेगा बिल सारे जमा हो जाते हैं मास्टर जी।
अरे वो, अरे वो भाई।
These vans are equipped with audiovisual facilities, internet connectivity and trainers to inform citizens in the most rural parts of the country about the importance of Aadhaar and the ease of availing various government services by getting online. We caught up with these trainers who are in many ways will become the face of flagship Digital India campaign to find out what their experience of getting online has been and what they believe they will achieve with this campaign.
गांव में पढ़े लिखे होते हुए भी इस चीज नए इंटरनेट के बारे में पिछड़ रहे हैं लोग। इसे गांव-गांव जाके यही दिखाना बताना है कि पढ़े लिखे लोगों को यही समझाना है कि नेट के जरिए घर बैठे ये छत के नीचे सब काम हो सकता है।
आप मुझे बताइए कि आप खुद अपने फोन के द्वारा क्या क्या इंटरनेट में क्या क्या एक्सेस करते हैं।
जैसे गूगल है, गूगल पर सब काम हो सकता है और मैप भी देख सकते हैं और सरकार की कोई भी योजना न्यूज है सब पढ़ सकते हैं नेट के जरिए।
But while these outreach vans are fully loaded, what happens to the aam aadmi when he steps out?
The biggest thing the government can do, and it's understood this and beginning to do it, is to create an enabling environment. An environment in which people can, you know, not only use all kinds of facilities but develop new apps which are required by the people. So one thing is to find the problems and then to look for solutions for them. The other is to enable people to be able to try out different alternatives and different solutions. But key to all this is connectivity. Therefore, if the government has two things, basic infrastructure is something only the government can and probably should do. And that's something which we really need to look at doing quickly and rapidly. We just got to get good broadband out across the country. That's critical.
So let's review some of the roadblocks to connectivity that have been overcome by the NDA government. Caught up with the Minister of Communications and IT as he travelled out from Mathura to address a public rally while on his Vikas Parv Yatra.
I'm going to begin by asking you, sir, that you've highlighted a lot of issues that have been tackled in the first 2 years as far as Digital India is concerned. But if you were to highlight for us that one big point that really stands out for you, that you really feel will be the game changer for the next 3 years and perhaps a lot more, what would that be?
First of all, the statistics part. India today, 100 crore plus mobile phone, 100 crore plus Aadhaar, 40 crore plus internet, 60 crore mobile. And the PM's vision, I want governance in the mobile hand of every Indian, is taking shape. Digital India today is being accepted by the people. And many of the common service centers whom I awarded today in Mathura, the kind of services they are giving. 36,000 crore plus of saving through Aadhaar direct payment.
Correct.
Jandhan, Aadhaar mobile.
Correct.
This trinity has sunk into the psyche of India.
Right.
And it is only going to go further and further. Just for the understanding of your viewers, Postal Department is into e-commerce delivery in a very big manner. We have 1,50,000 all over the country. Now, can you just believe their parcel revenue has risen by 80% plus? And the catchment area, 60% plus is small mofussil towns, villages. The aspirational India, that's what a smartphone is giving them. If you ask me, coming 3 years, it is going to further accelerate. And I not only see e-commerce, I see e-education, I see e-entertainment, I see e-health,
right,
all being driven by a smartphone. Why? From desktop to laptop to smartphone. And your digital desh which you promote is nothing but capturing the essence of change which India is undertaking through the help of that little baby called the smartphone.
Correct. So as far as the smartphone is concerned, and you brought up e-commerce, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about transforming the post office and the postal department. Would you say that one of the biggest achievements of your government has been to actually inject imagination into reinventing some of our oldest institutions?
Obviously. I always say this 150 years organization was like a respectable old lady in a village under deep ghungat. Okay, I said, come on, you have to go and see. Today, the postmen of India have found a new role for themselves to do the postal payment bank very soon. Now, we are going to give 1,30,000 moving ATM to my Gramin Dak Sevaks. You understand the kind of financial inclusion it will lead to. So many international companies from Barclays to Deutsche Bank to World Bank to Citibank are keen to partner. Therefore, it will be a game changer. And if I put it on a larger philosophical perspective, we missed the Industrial Revolution. We missed the entrepreneur exercise of 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s because of license permit quota raj.
Correct.
I am very keen to push digital revolution in India, Indians' innovation. And what is my take about Indians? First, they observe technology. Then they adopt it. Then they start enjoying it and they become empowered. And that's what we are doing. And the coming 3 years is only going to see the acceleration of this process.
All right. Since we're talking about accelerating this process, a big contribution to that would actually be internet penetration, would be good connectivity. In cities like Delhi, Bombay, also there is a problem as far as connectivity is concerned. We face it all the time in our daily lives. It only goes on to show that as we move away from Mathura into, the hinterland, what the situation might be. What are the steps that are being taken? Because a smartphone is effective only if it has connectivity and good connectivity which is cheap, which is affordable.
You are very right. Therefore, first thing what we are doing, we are connecting 250,000 gram panchayats of India by optical fiber network.
Okay.
And that is what got BharatNet.
Right.
And once we reach there, then by Wi-Fi, we wish to go to villages in which the common service centers have to play a crucial role. And since you talked of the speed and the scale, this was started as a NowFloats in 2011, when our government came only 358 kilometers. And in 2 years' time, we have added fiber at 118,000 kilometers. Okay? We'll do it in the coming 1.5 years or 2 years at the most. But what is important is, we are also reinforcing good connectivity in the hinterland, also in the urban areas. We have been very firm on them. They have installed about 100,000 new sites in the entire country. That we are monitoring. But remember one thing, since you talked about that, all the policies I have done, spectrum sharing, spectrum trading, harmonization, liberalization, sharing of infrastructure, active and passive. Therefore, no policy is pending. No means really no. We have also cleared the policy for virtual mobile network.
So now it is the onus of private enterprise and entrepreneurs?
Yes, obviously. And if they need something, I'm ready to do that more. This whole issue of radiation menace,
right.
I've been talking so publicly about it inside the parliament, outside the parliament. I took the lead on it. Therefore, as I always say, now all these policies pending for the last 7 to 10 years have been cleared. No policy paralysis. Okay, enough spectrum is there. We are going to auction 2100 megahertz of spectrum.
Correct.
Therefore, the scarcity of spectrum is a thing of the past.
Okay.
India is a huge market, 1 right. billion plus.
Right.
And in 4G you talked about, I have given license to Reliance Jio, to Airtel, to Vodafone, to Idea. Fair competition. Therefore, as a minister, I have done everything for creating the enabling atmosphere. But since you talked about that, I always say, a good, flawless service is not only in the interest of the consumers, but also for the integrity of the operators.
Correct.
And JAM ends with M, which is the mobile part. So I hope they will understand, because of our persuasion and pressure, they have done so much, they need to do more. That's all I can say.
The minister several times over referenced the work being done by the network of common service centers that have been set up across the country. So we paid one CSE located in Gantholi village near Govardhan to find out how these work and if they can actually develop into powerful agencies of digital accomplishment in the near future.
मैंने अब तक देखा था बहुत सी गवर्नमेंट आई उन्होंने बहुत योजनाएं उतारी हैं पर वो गांव के लोगों तक नहीं पहुंचती हैं फिर मैंने अपने यहां बैंकिंग काउंटर चलाया था उसके तहत थोड़ा बहुत नेट भी चलाता था धीरे-धीरे करके मैंने नेट से जानकारी जुटाई फिर मैंने सोचा कि एक आदमी अगर कंप्यूटर लिटरेट होकर ये बैंकिंग काउंटर ला सकता है तो ब्लॉक लेवल के अधिकारियों ने हमें बताया कि आप सीएससी सेंटर चलाइए उसके द्वारा मैंने देखा तो उसमें पहले 26 सेवाएं थी अभी सीएससी सेंटर पर और भी सेवाएं बढ़ गई हैं उनको जब एक आदमी कंप्यूटर चलाकर इतनी सेवाएं ला सकता है अगर गांव के 10 आदमी भी कंप्यूटर साक्षर होंगे तो गांव वालों के लिए ज्यादा सेवाएं लाएंगे मुझसे अभी कहा था एक लेडीज ने अरे लेडीज क्या करेंगे कंप्यूटर सीखकर अब तो हमें कोई जरूरत नहीं है कंप्यूटर सीखने की तो मैंने उनसे एक बात कहा था आपको जरूरत नहीं है पर आपके बच्चों को हो सकती है वो टैबलेट वगैरह चलाते हैं तो आपको उनकी नॉलेज होगी कि वो सही टैबलेट चला रहे हैं कोई उस पर गलत कार्य तो नहीं कर रहे हैं आपको तो नॉलेज ये तो जान सकते हो कि हमारा बच्चा क्या कर रहा है
And now with the Reserve Bank of India granting the nodal PSU company CSC E-Governance Services India Limited with license to offer online billing services to allow people in rural clusters to pay their electricity, water bills as well as get phone top-up recharges at a single point, the Common Service Centre is now a payment gateway of sorts too. On that note, it's time for us to take a break, but we continue our road trip through India. We'll talk to a new age pandit in Pushkar, find out how Richard Gere made a home visit to dari maker Roop Rajji, and meet an entrepreneurial duo from Jodhpur who are selling everything from pure breed Marwari horses to World War II jeeps online. Stay tuned for that and more.
The Young Turks 14 years.